Dean, thanks for joining me. It was a good workout for the lads tonight. What was your assessment on both the performances?
Yeah, it's week two. It's tough for the boys. You know, they walked their socks off yesterday. And we've been in, that's our aid session. So the only day we've had off is Sunday. We started the Monday before last. So yeah, pleased. Pleased to win. Always good to win. It's a good habit to have. And good to get a clean sheet. But I thought it was a very competitive game. I thought Gary's team asked a lot of questions of us physically. And they show good fitness levels as well, Bedford. So very competitive game and a good walkout.
So you just mentioned it's only week two. There's plenty of positives to take from tonight's performance.
Yeah, you want to see good habits. You know, different phases of the game. We had to deal with different things physically. And they got down the sides of us a couple of times. But I thought Garmo, really, when we got him on the ball, made us play. That's what he does. A couple of little things where lads just got to get used to each other as well. So, but we have to remember, we walked our socks off. Yesterday, we did a double session yesterday, so it is still pre-season. The results do help. They breed a bit of confidence. Performance definitely breeds a bit of confidence, but it's all about our fitness levels at this moment in time.
So we made plenty of changes over the summer, but how do you feel like the team's gelling at the minute?
Yeah, good lads. Character, went for character. Looked at a lot of players in the recruitment department that have played the majority of last season, or the last two seasons. Thought that was important. Obviously, people knew last year I was very frustrated with a treatment room being full all the time. And hopefully that's not the case this year, because like I say, we've recruited players that played the majority of the games for the previous clubs. And we want to be more athletic than what we were last year. That's so important as well. So I'm happy with the way things have gone so far. So long may that continue. It's like anything, Howard, you know, when it comes to recruiting players, you have to be patient. Some players want to play higher, some in conversation for a long amount of the summer. So I think the business we've done is good. The average age of our team is 20, the average age of our squad is 25.3 at this moment in time. We'd always like to add a couple more. I think that's important. The next couple we get is so important to our group, and hopefully they can have a clean build, clean pre-season, and stay fit. I think that'll give us a good foundation really to have a solid season. That's sort of the plan.
And how pleased are you to get the business done early on in pre-season as well?
Vital. Well, I got done the off-season, I'll be honest. Didn't really have much days off myself. Everyone else was off, but I didn't really have much days off myself. But that don't matter. That's what the job is all about. If you want to be successful, you've got to make sacrifices. So, yeah, happy that we've got 95% of the squad done at this moment in time. But with anything, you know, results, fixtures, when the season starts, things can change. We've just got to stay on top of things, keep taking it 1 week at a time, 1 day at a time, and that's what we'll do.
The games are going to be coming thick and fast between now and the start of the season. What are you looking to get out of the next few weeks?
It's planned. It's you know, everything's meticulously planned. The first 3 weeks are all individual for the players. It's all about their individual fitness and base fitness, and the last 3 weeks of pre-season, 6 weeks pre-season, is all about the team and how we gel and how we want to play and how we deal with different things with the National League throws at you. You know, some days you're gonna, like today, first half, they were quite physical with us. That's what's going to happen in our division. Talk the target man and the lad run down the channels in the two-man front line was caused us problems. So we're going to have to deal with that. You're going to have to go to Wrexham away and deal with their long throws. So there's so much to deal with. You will have to deal with technical teams. And I think the division's as strong as ever again this year with the teams that have come up and the teams that have come down. So there's no easy games in the National League. But we're relishing it. We're looking forward to it. And we're excited.
And just back tonight, obviously, that we had a minute's applause for the Barnet supporter who's passed away recently, Robin Goldman, and it was great to see everyone, both sides of staff and supporters, join in with that.
Yeah, I think Bedford showed a lot of class in that. We requested that. Village spoke to me the other day about it, and we want to send our condolences to Robin's family. It's tragic what's happened, really, and we want to God bless him. May you rest in peace from all of us, you know, on the playing staff and the coaching staff. And it's really sad. And like I say, Bedford showed a lot of class, and so did their supporters. So it was nice to see.
And just finally, how much did you enjoy being back out on the touchline today and back amongst the atmosphere and the stadium?
Yeah, really enjoyed it. Good atmosphere tonight, wasn't it? It was a good game, to be fair. Laurie had a lot of saves to make, so delighted to be back out here. And you know, on to the next. The boys are in again tomorrow morning. They've got a really, really tough session again tomorrow, so we're looking forward to it.
Nice time, Stevie.